All right, here's the tutorial for tomorrow's test. There are going to be three extra credit problems. In them, you're going to find some equivalent resistance. So they're really not too bad, even though they might seem a little bit overwhelming. First, let's look at each of the three problems. They'll be these ones, this one at the top, this one right here, let's call it problem one. Then there will be this one here, let's call it problem two. And then there will be problem three. Now, I don't know exactly how many points you'll get for each one, but I will tell you, you'll get more for problem three than you will for problem two than you will for problem one. They kind of go up in difficulty to match. So let's look first at problem number one. Problem number one is really not too bad. We've got some resistors that are in series, like our 10 ohm and our 15 ohm resistor at the top and the accompanying 15 and 20 ohm resistor below it. The first thing to do, let's try to combine some resistors here. Let's combine some of these that are in series, and then we'll worry about the ones that are in parallel. So we have our battery here. We're going to combine this 10 ohm and this 15 ohm together. When they combine together, they are going to combine into their own 25 ohm resistor. Then we're going to combine this 15 ohm and this 20 ohm in, and they're going to combine into their own 35 ohm resistor. Then we move on, that 40 ohm will still be there. Actually, let's not put that 40 ohm there. Instead, instead of putting that 40 ohm resistor there, let's combine this 40, this 80, and this 120. So when they combine together, they will combine to, let's say 40 and 80 and 120. They're going to combine to 240 ohm resistor right there. And then that's the whole circuit. And we go back to our battery. So we're getting closer, ready to move on to yet another set of combinations. Here, let's set up a new circuit. Now we're going to combine this 25 and this 35 together. 25 and 35 go together according to the parallel rule, because they're in parallel, where 1 over R total is 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. In this case, 1 over R total is 1 over 25 ohms plus 1 over 35 ohms, which is equal to 0.069. Thus, our total will be 14.58 ohms. So this resistor will be 14.58. It runs in series with a 240. Like that. So our one last step that we need to do to find the equivalent resistance of this one is combine those two together. They will combine into a resistor that has 254.6 ohms of total resistance. And there is problem number one. Let's look at problem number two now. Number two is looking a little funny for us right now. There it is. Okay, number two, again, really not too bad. We're gonna take a couple steps at once in this one. We're gonna start with our battery. We're gonna come across. Let's start and combine these two, the 8-ohm. Let's combine the 8-ohm and the 16-ohm together to make one resistor. 8 and 16 will combine together to make a single 24-ohm resistor. Now, we're going to go in and combine sets in this section here first. This 20 and this 40 and this 40, they are in series with each other. So we're going to plug those together, and we're going to plug them into their own 100 ohm resistor right there. Now we need to go back and take a look at this branch here. And this one, that 60 and that 40 will combine into their 100 ohm resistor. And down on the bottom, we're going to leave that 20 where it is. And then, oh, excuse me. Then this 40 and this 40 together, they will combine into make their own 20 ohm resistor according to the parallel rule. Now, things continue to get a little bit easier as we move on. As we take our next step of simplification, we'll leave our 24 ohm there. This 100 and this 100 right here will combine to make a 50 ohm resistor. 50, not 56. And then across the bottom, those two will form a 40 ohm resistor. When we combine those into one, then we get 24 and 50 and 40 comes out to be a single resistor that is 114 ohms. There's the equivalent resistance of number two. Let's go on to problem number three. Number three looks a little nasty. As we start to break it down, it's really not all that bad. Let's start, when we combine these ones together, let's start, as always, is my preference, combining everything that is in series into one resistor. And we kind of clean up the page a little bit. So that means we're gonna start with, let's start with this 60 and this 90. We're gonna do that one first. Then we're gonna do these ones second. Then we're gonna do these ones third. So first, we're gonna take that 60 and that 90 ohm at the top. They are gonna combine into their own 150 ohm resistor. Parallel to that, there's another 150 ohm resistor as well. As we scroll back up, let's take a look at what we've got next. Next, we go on to set number two. I'm gonna draw four and six. They'll combine into their own 10 ohm resistor. And then even though this other 10, this one right here, even though it is set diagonally, I'm gonna redraw it so it's not diagonal. Rather than making it diagonal, I'm going to come down from here and make it vertical. And that makes it a little easier to see that these two 10 ohm resistors are in parallel, and we'll use that to our advantage later, that it's easy to tell that it's parallel. So we go down that 18 and that 18 there, these sets, these 18 ohm resistors. I'm gonna do the same thing with these. When I redraw them here, I'm going to make it a little more obvious that they are parallel to each other. And then, let's see, where do we have? We have a 12-ohm resistor we need to plug in there. And then along the bottom, there's a 22. In the top, set number 3, right here, we've got that 2-ohm. That 2-ohm creates an equivalent resistance of 22 right there. There we have it. So we've simplified a little bit. Still looking a little ugly. Let's continue on a little bit. Right now, the next step, let's combine some parallels together. First, we're going to look at this set. We're going to call this set 1. This one will be set 2. The 10 ohms will be 2. These two 18 ohm resistors will be set 3. And these two 22s will be set 4. We're going to leave that 12 ohm resistor alone for a bit. So as we redraw it again, those two 150 ohm resistors in set 1 will combine to be a new 75 ohm resistor. They'll go across. Those two 10s will combine to be a 5 ohm according to the parallel rule. Remember the parallel rule says that 1 over R total equals 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 and so on. So in the case of the two 10 ohm resistors, we have 1 over R total equals 1 over 10 plus 1 over 10, which equals 2 tenths, which equals 1 fifth. But remember, that's 1 over R total. So R total is 5 ohms for this set right here. Let's move back on down. We've got that set 2. Let's look at set number 3, 18 ohm resistors. They're going to combine to make 9 ohms. That 12 ohm resistor we're going to plug in there. And then these two 22 ohms, they're going to be 11. So now you can see things are getting a little more simple to work through. We're going to use the series rule now, where R total equals R1 plus R2 plus R3 and so on. So in this case, let's make one more. The last and final simplification. We're going to take our 75 ohm resistor plus our 5 ohm resistor plus our 9 ohm plus our 12 plus our 11. And it's going to say 112 ohms is our total resistance for that circuit. So that means that this circuit right here behaves exactly the same way as does this big ugly thing right here. So there's some series and parallel combination circuits that can be simplified into equivalent resistances. Tomorrow's test will include a couple of extra credit ones of these. If you've been clever enough to find them on the online test review, congratulations. Take a look over them if you need to. We'll have these 3. You'll be able to pick one of them to do. Good luck.